Hi everyone and welcome to this new episode of my Ivan's vlog all about balls and a little bit more. And today I'm gonna talk a little bit more about how to inflate a ball the right way, but version 2, because my first video had a lot of positive reactions, also a lot of questions, and that's also why I made this special episode as well. So welcome to this episode. So like I said in the intro, today we're going to talk a little bit more about the equipment that I use to inflate the balls the right way, because I got a lot of questions about that. I also answered it in the previous episode, but I don't think too much people viewed that video, so that's also why I make this new one. Also going to inflate a ball that I received a couple of days ago from a team here in Belgium that also plays in the CEV Cup, and that's also then how I'm going to explain how to inflate the ball the right way. First of all, let's talk about the equipment. So first of all, this is the thing that I always use to inflate the balls. It's a Select valve oil. It costs me around €6, but this is amazing stuff. You can also find it on Amazon as well, but I will also post a couple of links in the description down below, and then you can easily find where to buy this amazing valve oil. It's really thin, and you only have to use about 2 droplets, and that's also a really good investment. I think maybe I have to buy this bottle twice a year maybe, so it's €12 per year. I think you can still manage it. Also, what is important, that's the needles, because you have to inflate a ball through the valve and then you need a needle. And this one I bought at Decathlon here in Belgium, and it was, I think, around €2-3, yeah. But the most important thing about this, it uses a round head, and I think that's also crucial if you don't want to puncture the ball when you try to inflate the ball as well. So always look for a ball needle with a round head. This is, I think, really important too. Then, of course, we need this, and I don't know if I can frame it, but I'm gonna do it like this. So, this is a ball pump. You can choose whichever ball pump you wanna use. If you want to use a ball pump that normally is being used to inflate rubber tires of a bicycle, no problem at all. You can also use this. But I had this still laying around, and I said, oh yeah, this is a really good pump, so I'm still gonna use it for inflating the balls as well. And of course, what you also need is something to check the pressure. And most people, I think, will buy this one. It's just a cheap analog one. This is from Arima, and it cost me €13, I think, 10 years ago. I think the price will also be the same as it was then, so maybe €13-14, but it's still perfect. If you want to go a little bit more expensive for checking the ball pressure, I can also recommend this one. And this is a digital gauge. So, of course, because this is analog, the problem is, of course, there's also a little bit of a margin. It's not always 100% perfect, but if you use a digital gauge, then of course the pressure you will see on the screen is absolutely perfect. And for volleyball, it's definitely necessary because it is a low tolerance. The ball has to be between 0.3 and 0.33 bars, so the margin is really small. So that's also why we use this digital gauge at the games at home. So I think this costs around €60, but I will also put it in the description down below too, so you can find it and you can also buy it if you want to. And this is also from Mikasa itself, and really good one. There is also, as you can see when I open it, you can also see 2 needles. They already come included, so that's also really easy for people if you don't want to buy needles yourself. It's already here, so that's also perfect. So in short, I will repeat what is necessary to inflate a ball. So first of all, you need the oil, you need a needle, you need a pump, of course, because otherwise it's going to be a little bit problematic. And then a ball gauge, the analog or the digital one, you can choose whichever you want. And that's also why I'm going to explain this when I inflate the ball that I have received. And this is also something I'm going to say in my next episode. I have received a Mikasa V200W CEV. That was it. So the Mikasa V200W CEV. And it's also the same version as the new Mikasa ball, the V200W, but with different colors, because it's for CEV games. So I'm also going to explain in this video how you can perfectly inflate the ball the right way. So stick around. And so now it is time to inflate this beautiful ball that I have received from the club VC Greenyard Mazak. As you can see, the ball is totally deflated. So I insert a few droplets of the ball valve oil. And I start with two or three, and then I check with my ball gauge if this is enough or not. So that's also first thing I do. I try to get the oil in as deep as I can by inserting the ball. As you can see, it's still a little bit on the stiff side. So always be careful if you do that. And if you're not 100% sure, just like I do, just insert a few extra droplets as well. And that's also what I do here. And I think that was the best solution because I was not 100% happy. If you feel a little bit of something that's not 100% perfect, just insert a few extra droplets, and now it's absolutely perfect, as you can see. The ball came deflated, so it was a little bit easier for them for shipping, but I'm really happy with it. But now, of course, I have to inflate the ball myself. First, I dry off the excess oil that's still on the ball. I take my ball pump from Mikasa, really happy with this pump, like I said also a little bit earlier. Now I try to insert the needle inside the valve, but the valve is a little bit on the difficult side to get into, but I tried and it was not totally in, but I started to inflate the ball just a little bit to be sure that the ball was getting round. And I took out the needle because I was not really happy, it was not fully inserted yet. So first of all, I tried to insert my ball gauge again to see if there was something sticking inside the valve, but I think it was perfect. So still a little bit on the stiff side, so an extra few droplets. Like I said, always better to be safe than sorry. Just add a few extra droplets, and as you can see, now it's absolutely perfect. So now I can pump the ball until it's beautifully round. And with this ball pump, there's also not too much pressure. So that's also perfect for inflating a volleyball. A soccer ball needs a little bit more. It needs almost one bar of air, but this is only 0.3. So with this ball pump, it's the air flows not too fast on the inside of the ball. So it gets its roundness perfectly. And you can also see a lot of scuff marks because this ball has been used during an actual game. So for me, this was absolutely amazing for my collection as well. So I check with my fingers if the ball is okay or not. That's also something I do before I check it with my ball gauge. Now I insert the ball gauge and I will see what the pressure is. Unfortunately, it was not framed perfectly, so I saw it in my LCD screen, and now you also can see it. It's 0.4, just a little bit on the high side, but I want it like that because the ball still has wrinkles, and you want to get the wrinkles out, so that's also why I overpressurized the ball just a little bit, 0.4, that's absolutely perfect. So now clean off the excess oil, and the ball looks finished. Oh man, this ball looks amazing. Yeah, it's still a little bit weird because we also tried to use the MVA 200, and this time it's the V200W, and as you can see,
there is a special marking on the ball which said number one, so this ball was effectively used during the game, or maybe a couple of games of the CEV games that the VC Grignard Mazaïque played at home. Really, really happy with this ball. It's the new version, and this colors scheme looks amazing. And here's the finished product, and as you can see, it's an amazing ball for my collection.
So, thank you for watching this episode. If you have some questions, don't hesitate. Just put them down below in the comments and I will respond as fast as possible. If you want, you can also find me on Instagram or on Facebook. If you want, just ask me and I will add you on my Instagram as well. So, thank you for watching this episode. Don't forget to subscribe. Also, hit the bell icon if you want to receive notifications. And leave a comment down below, and then I will respond as fast as possible. Thank you for watching this episode, and see you next time. Bye. So, when it comes to equipment, first of all, I bought this. I'm also going to show a close-up, because this is going to be a little bit more difficult to frame, I think. And that's why we have to wait a little bit. Konden jullie al een uur wachten?